This is the structure of factory method pattern. Here is the example of factory method pattern. We will see how this is implemented in CPP source. Here is the class project. It has method addFile. It's a pure virtual function, so will be implemented in its derived classes. Here is the class Unisys project, derived from class project, and implements the method addFile. And here is the class IBM project, derived from class project, and implements the method addFile. Here is the class project creator. It has data member project of class project. Here is the method create project. It's a pure virtual function, so will be implemented in its derived classes. Here is the method new project. Inside new project method, it calls the method create project and then returns the project. Here is the class Unisys project creator, derived from class project creator, and implements the method create project. And inside this method, it creates the object of Unisys project and returns it. So here project is assigned with Unisys project and it returns the Unisys project. Here is the class IBM project creator, derived from class project creator, and implements the method create project. And inside this, it creates the object of IBM project and returns it. So in this case, project will be assigned with IBM project and it will return the IBM project object. Okay, let's see the main. Here is the variable proj. Here is the variable proj creator of project creator, and the proj is of project. We are creating the object of Unisys project creator. Then new project method is called. So new project is in the project creator and it will call the create project, which in turn will call the create project of Unisys project creator, and it will create the object of Unisys project and it will return it here, and this will return it here and it will assign to the proj. Then addFile method is called. Since the object created was Unisys project object, so it will call the method addFile of Unisys project. Similarly, here IBM project creator object is created and then new project is called. So in the new project, it will call create project, and here it will come to the create project of IBM project creator and it will create the IBM project object. And when we call the addFile method, it will call the addFile method of IBM project. Okay, we will run this program and we will see the output. Okay, here is the output. So first one, project creator new. When new project is called, it goes to the project creator new project method, and inside new project method, create project is called. So first time it goes to Unisys project creator, create project, and here the add file method is called, so it goes to Unisys project add file method. Similarly here when new project is called, it goes to the project creator new project method, which in turn call the create project of IBM project creator. And since it's a IBM project object, it goes to the add file of IBM project method.